Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. This is our second lecture on Class 12, Chapter 5, Exercise 5.2. In our first lecture, what we have discussed? We discussed how we calculate the adjoint of our matrices, and we already discussed short tricks to calculate the adjoint of a matrix. In this lecture, we have to take the short tricks for the adjoints, because this topic is totally based on your adjoints of a matrix. The name of the topic is inverse. The first question of exercise 5.2 is find the inverse of the following matrix. It means in this lecture we are going to calculate the inverse for a matrix, and we have to discuss different properties related to the inverse. So what is inverse? The basic formula for the inverse is, if you calculate A inverse, the inverse is represented by raised to the power negative 1. Negative 1 basically indicates that we have to find out, or that we are going to find out the inverse for a matrix. So which is basically nothing, is basically adjoints for a matrix divided by determinant of the matrix. I again repeat, the what's the formula we have to use to find out the inverse for a matrix? A inverse is equal to adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. It means we already discussed both of these terms, because in the first lecture we already taken how we calculate the adjoint for the matrix, and when I'm talking about the determinants, we already taken in our chapter 4. So both of these terms we already explained. So we have to just put all these terms in the formula for the A inverse, and we get the inverse of a matrix. So try to do our first question. Our first question is A, B, C and D. I request those students who still not watch my first video, please watch my first video, because this concept is based on the previous lecture. Firstly, we have to calculate the determinant. What is its determinants? This is your matrix, let A. Then what will be the determinant of it? A determinant is equal to cross multiplication. A into D, we get AD, minus B into C, we get BC. It means the determinant of A is AD minus BC, which is not equal to 0. Please make a note here, the determinant never be equal to 0, because if the determinant becomes equal to 0, it becomes a singular matrix. And if we put the determinant in the formula for the A inverse, what is the result? If the determinant is 0, it means the denominator part is 0, it becomes the undefined terms. Means we cannot calculate the A inverse, because A inverse is undefined. That's why the determinant of the matrix which you want to calculate its inverse should not be equal to 0. It should be a non-singular matrix. So A is a non-singular matrix. So firstly you have to calculate the determinants, because whenever we calculate the determinants, we got the idea our matrix is singular or non-singular. If the matrix is singular, then we cannot find the inverse. If the matrix is non-singular, then we have to do the process to calculate the inverse for a matrix. We already calculated the determinants. Now our second step, we have to calculate the adjoints for a matrix. And how we calculate the adjoints? I am using shortcut method. How we calculate the adjoints? Adjoint of A, which is the matrix of A is A, B, C, D, and we have to calculate its adjoints. And what will be the adjoints? Simplest is you have to interchange the diagonal elements, so we get D and A, and the remaining elements are as it is, and the sign of each element becomes change. So this element is positive, it becomes negative, and this element is again positive, we get negative. So we got adjoint of A is D minus B minus C and A. Now we have to put all this stuff in the formula. Then A inverse is equal to adjoint of A. A inverse is equal to adjoint of A. We got adjoint of A is D minus B minus C A divided by determinant of A. Determinant of A is AD minus BC. You can write in simplified form A inverse is equal to 1 upon me AD minus BC D minus B minus C and A. This is the A inverse. I hope you understand this. For those students who still not watched my first video, I am going to explain this question in a standard format according to a 10th level. So firstly you have to make this now. For those students who still not watched my first video, I am going to explain a brief introduction how we calculate the adjoints according to a 10th level, because here we taken the short tricks, because if we go to step by step, this becomes very lengthy and this video becomes very wide. So that's why I'm taking all the questions and all the properties as a short tricks. But you have to write in your clear notebook according to a 10th or according to a 12th standard. But it's firstly you have to calculate the cofactors of each element. So our first element, we have to calculate the cofactor of A11. A11 means we have to choose first row and first column. If we remove first row and first column, we get D. Now we have to remove first row, second column. First row, second column, with which we get C. Now we have to remove second row, first column. Second row and first column, we get B. Similarly, if we remove second row, second column, we get A. And you know what's the sign for whenever you calculate the cofactor for any matrix? You have to calculate the sum 1 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2, even. It means sign not be changed. So this will be remains same. A12, 2 plus 1, which is equal to 3, which is odd. It means we have to change the sign. So we get negative C. Again 2 plus 1, 3, odd. We have to change the sign. Now 2 plus 2, 4, even. So sign will not be changed. So we get the cofactor elements. And if we put all the cofactor elements in the matrix, we get a cofactor matrix. So now I am going to put all the cofactors in the matrix. What's the cofactor of A11 is D. Cofactor of A11, A12 is minus C. A21 is minus B and A22 is A. And what is the formula for the adjoint? Adjoint basically a cofactor matrix transpose. You can say the transpose of the cofactor matrix. We already got the cofactor matrix, so we have to do its transpose. We have to change row into column. So we get D minus C, and this row becomes column minus D and A. This is your same. I hope you understand this. Now I am going to take each and every question of 2 cross 2 in shortcut method. So now we can prove all the question as fast. But we have to do according to your this level in your fair notebook and in your final exam. Because short trick you can be used only in your competitive exam, not in your final exam. So please make a note first. Now this is our second part of question 1. So you have, this is a shortcut tricks to calculate the inverse for a 2 cross 2 matrix in just 5 seconds. Why it is? Because it's very simple. If we use shortcut, then we can calculate the adjoint inverse for a 2 cross 2 matrix in within 5 seconds. How it is? We know. Firstly, we have to write the adjoints, then we have to divide its determinant. And we already know how we calculate. So please make a look here. A inverse basically is equal to adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. So what's the adjoint? Means we have to interchange the elements. So we get 5, 2. And change the remaining signs, we get minus 3, minus 3. And we know what's the determinant? Determinant is cross multiplication. 2 into 5 which is 10 minus 3 into 3 which is 9. It means we get 10 minus 9 1. So we get the same element. This is the answer. This is very short tricks to calculate the A inverse within only 5 seconds. So keep this as a short tricks in your, you can apply it in your competitive exams. But in final exam you have to do the all the steps, but I am here taking shortcut tricks. Now our next question is 1001. Now the what's the answer is? A inverse is adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. What's the adjoints? Interchange the elements 1 and 1. We get the same element, and the other element we have to change the sign. 0 sign changes, also 0. So we get 0. What's the determinant? 1 into 1, 1 minus 0 into 0, 0. So we get 1. So answer is 1001. This is your final answer. This is super shortcut for the inverse for 2 cross 2 matrix. Please make a note first. Now I am going to take our next question, question number 2 from exercise 5.2 from element mathematics. Find the inverse of the matrix A 3, 5, 7, minus 11. And verify, we have to verify A into A inverse which is equal to A inverse into A which is equal to I2. What it is? Please make a note here, this is our property. If you multiply any matrix with its inverse matrices, or you can change the order, inverse matrices multiply with its matrix, we get an identity matrix. Identity matrix means I matrix, or you can say that unit matrix, which has all elements, diagonal elements 1 and remaining elements are 0. So N is basically for the order of the your square matrix. In this matrix which basically 2 cross 2 square matrix, so N is here 2. That's in this question put as I2, but the standard form is IN. N is the order of the square matrix. So this becomes a question, but it is actually a property of the inverse matrix. So please make a note first. Now firstly we have to calculate the inverse, and we know what the inverse is. Adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. This is 2 cross 2, so we are using shortcut method. We have to interchange the elements, we get minus 11, 3, and change the sign of the diagonal elements, minus 5 and minus 7. This is our adjoint. And what's the determinant? 3 into minus 11 which is minus 33, minus 7 into 5, 35, which is equal to minus 11, minus 5, minus 7, 3, divided by minus 68. So we can also write in terms of A inverse is equal to 1 upon 68. If we divide by negative to all the elements, we can all change the sign. So this becomes positive, 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 and this becomes negative. So this is our A inverse. Now we have to verify its property. So we have to put all this here. So firstly keep it, firstly make a note first, then I will rub this property. So start. We have to verify this. Firstly, we have to put A. What is A? 3, 5, 7, minus 11. What is A inverse is 1 upon 68 multiply 11, 5, 7, minus 3, which is equal to, again, right, this is our middle term. We write 1 by 68, 11, 5, 7, minus 3, into A. A is your 3, 5, 7, minus 11. And this is our right hand side, which is equal to I2. I2 is basically 1, 0, 0, 1. This is your identity matrix or unit matrix. Now we have to solve this. So this is your scalar number, and we can move either to the right hand side and to the left hand side, because it doesn't affect the matrices. So I am writing 1 by 68 before the matrix. 1 by 68. Now we have to do multiply. 3 into 11, which is equal to 33. 5 into 7, which is 35. 3 into 5, which is 15. 5 into minus 3, minus 15. 7 into 11, 77. 7 into minus 7, which is minus 77. 7 into 5, 35, plus minus 11 into minus 3, plus 33. Same here, I am doing multiplication. 11 into 3, 33. 5 into 7, 35. 11 into 5, 55. 5 into 11, minus 55. 7 into 3, 21. Minus 3 into 7, minus 21. 7 into 5, 35. Minus 3 into minus 11, plus 33. Now solve this. 1 upon me 68, which is 68, 0, 0, 68. Again here, this becomes 68, 0, 0, 68. If we divide by 68 each element, but figure only 1 and 0. So this becomes 1, 0, 0, 1. This also becomes 1, 0, 0, 1. This is equal to your, which is your equal to I. So we are verified. So please make a note. A into A inverse, which is equal to A inverse into A, which is equal to I. If you multiply any matrix with its inverse, we get identity matrix. So make a note first. Now this is your question number 3. Find the inverse. We already did the inverse for a 2 cross 2 square matrix. But now the question is in terms of square matrix of order 3 into 3. So this there is no shortcut to do find out the adjoints directly. So we have to use the standard format. So firstly, we have to make a cofactor matrix. That's why we have to write its cofactors of each elements. So I am finding our cofactor of first element, which one is A11, first row and first column. If we remove first row and first column, we get 1, minus 1, minus 3, 2. Now we are finding A12, first row, second column. What we will got? 2, 4, minus 1, 2. Now first row, third column, we get 2, 1, 4, minus 3. Second row, first column, we got minus 2, 3, minus 3, 2. Now we move second row, second column, we got 3, 4, 3, 2. Third, first, second row, third column is 3, minus 2, 4, minus 3. Now third row, first column, third row, first column, we got minus 2, 1, 3, minus 2. Third row, second column, third row, second column, we got 3, टू थ्री माइनस वन. नाउ थर्ड रो थर्ड कॉलम थर्ड रो थर्ड कॉलम वी गॉट थ्री टू माइनस टू वन. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस. नाउ वी हैव टू सॉल्व दिस. टू इंटू वन टू माइनस माइनस थ्री इंटू माइनस वन थ्री. सो वी गेट माइनस वन. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. टू इंटू टू फोर माइनस फोर इंटू माइनस वन माइनस फोर. सो दिस बिकम्स प्लस फोर विच इज एट. माइनस थ्री इंटू टू माइनस सिक्स. फोर इंटू वन फोर माइनस वन. वी गेट माइनस टेन. सॉल्व दिस. टू इंटू माइनस टू माइनस फोर माइनस माइनस थ्री इंटू माइनस थ्री माइनस नाइन. सो माइनस माइनस बिकम्स प्लस नाइन. वी गेट फाइव. सॉल्व दिस. टू इंटू थ्री सिक्स. फोर इंटू थ्री ट्वेल्व. सो वी गेट माइनस सिक्स. माइनस थ्री इंटू थ्री माइनस नाइन. माइनस फोर इंटू माइनस टू माइनस एट. सो माइनस माइनस बिकम्स एट. वी गेट माइनस वन. माइनस टू इंटू माइनस वन वी गेट टू. माइनस थ्री इंटू वन थ्री. वी गेट माइनस वन. थ्री इंटू माइनस वन माइनस थ्री. माइनस थ्री इंटू टू सिक्स. वी गेट माइनस नाइन. सो थ्री इंटू वन थ्री. माइनस टू इंटू माइनस टू माइनस फोर. सो माइनस माइनस बिकम्स फोर सेवन. बट टिल वी गॉट द माइनर एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द कोफैक्टर. सो वी हैव टू चेंज द साइन. If the sum of rows plus column is odd, we have to change the sign, otherwise the sign will be remains same. So here 1 1 is even, so the elements will be remain same. So we get minus 1. I'm writing here minus 1. 1 plus 2 3 odd, it means we have to change the sign. Sign is 8, so we get the sign minus 8. 1 plus 3 even, the sign remains same minus 10. 8, 2, 1, 2 plus 1, 3, odd. We have to change the sign. Sign becomes minus 5. 8, 2, 2, 2, 2 plus 4. 4 means even. The sign remains same. 2 plus 3, 5, odd. We have to change the sign. 1. 3 plus 1, 4. Even. Sign will be same. 3 plus 2, 5, odd. Sign will be changed. 3 plus 3, 6. Even sign will be same. So we get these elements. So please make a note first and check these cofactors are same or not. All elements are same. So we get our matrix, cofactor matrix, and if we have to find out the adjoints, then what will be the adjoint? Adjoint is transpose of the cofactor matrix. It means we have to transpose this. So row is changed into column. So our first row is minus 1, minus 8, minus 10. Second row is minus 5, minus 6, 1. And third row is minus 1, 9, 7. This is our adjoint of a matrix. So this make a note first, then we have to calculate this determinants and rough this portion. So please make a note first. Now our second step is we have to find the determinants. We are assuming this matrix as A, and what will be the determinant of A is 3, 2, 4, minus 2, 1, minus 3, 3, minus 1, 2. I again want to introduce this is the matrix and this is the determinant, because if the square bracket is replaced by parallel line, then it becomes a determinant form. So we have to expand along any row and every column. I am choosing our first row R1. Extend along R1. So we have to write all the elements of row first. So first element is 3, second element is minus 2, and third element is 3. And first sign is positive, second is negative, third is positive. So it becomes positive, it becomes negative, it becomes positive. Now we have to find out the determinants. Same, we have to remove first row and first column. First row and first column we get 1, minus 3, minus 1, 2. Second column and first row we get 2, 4, minus 1, 2. First row, third column, we get 2, 1, 4, minus 3. Now solve this. 3 into 1 into 2, 2, minus, minus 3 into minus 1, 3, minus minus plus 2, 2 into 2, 4, minus 4 into minus 1, minus 4, so minus minus becomes positive, we get 4, plus 3, minus 3 into 2, minus 6, 4 into 1, minus 4. So what will the result? 3 into 2 minus 3, minus 1, plus 2, 4 plus 4, 8, plus 3, minus 6 and minus 4, minus 10, we get minus 3, plus 16, minus 30. So this becomes minus 33, and this is plus 16. So we get minus 70. Make a note first. Our result is correct. Minus 17 is not equal to 0. So it means it is a non-singular matrix and we can calculate its inverse. Because if we got here 0, then the inverse of the matrix is not possible. Now, what's the inverse? The inverse is adjoint of the matrix divided by determinant of the matrix. What is the adjoints? Minus 1, minus 8, minus 10, minus 5, minus 6, 1, minus 1, 9, 7, and divide by determinants, which is equal to minus 17. So here is negative. I am dividing all the elements by minus 1, so we can change the negative sign. We got 1 by 17. This becomes positive 1, 8, 10. This becomes 5, 6, 1, minus 1. This becomes 1, minus 9, and minus 7. This is your final answer. Make a note. Our next question is question number 5. The remaining parts of the question 3 and the question number 4 is same as that we already did in our question number 3 first part. All the questions are same. So you have to do it, all this question, do it yourself. You have to do it at yourself. Now all we have to do our question number 5. But it's, please make a read. If A matrix is equal to this and A into B, which is equal to B into A, which is equal to I, and we have to find the D. So this question is very very important, so please keep it in mind. This is very important property, and 1 marks question always we put in such type of results. What's the result is, if A into B is equal to B into A, which is equal to I, then A is called the invertible matrix and B is called the inverse of the matrix A. Again I repeat, if A into B is equal to B into A is equal to I, then A is called the invertible matrix and B is called the inverse of A. So A is called the invertible matrix and B is called the inverse of A. Keep it in mind. And you can also take, if this follows, so you can also call that B is an invertible matrix, then A will be the inverse of B. So keep it in mind. This is very 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 important property. So 1 marks question will always be put such type of property based. So firstly we have to find out the B matrix. It means firstly we have to verify A into B or B into A is equal to I or not. If it is, then we have to find only the inverse of A, we get the matrix B. So please make a note first, then we have to do verifications A into B and is equal to B into A, which is equal to I. Please make a note first. So in this question, AB is equal to B into A is equal to I. This is already given. So this question is very simple. Because A into B is equal to B into A is equal to I, so that is B is inverse of the A matrix, because you have given A matrix and you have to calculate the matrix B. If this equation is satisfied, this equation is already given, because this statement is already proved. It means what's the B matrix is? B matrix is basically the inverse of your A matrix. So we have to calculate the A inverse, and we have already do. Firstly, we have to calculate the cofactors. Now I'm going again to calculate the cofactor of each element. So firstly, I'm calculating A11. First row and first column we got 5, 4, 9, 7. Second column, first row, we got 1, 6, 9, 7. First row, third column, we get 1, 6, 5, 4. Second row, first column, we got 0, 2, 6, 7. Second row, second column, we got 3, 6, 2, 7. Second row, third column, we got 3, 0, 6, 4. Third row, first column, we got 0, 5, 2, 9. Third row, first column, we got, sorry, here we again write. Now we have to calculate the A3, 2. Third row, second column, we got 3, 1, 2, 9. What is A33? Remove third row, third column, we got 3, 1, 0, 5. Now solve this. 7 into 5, 35. 9, 4 are 36. It means we get -1. And A11, which is even, so sign will be same. We get -1. Now solve this. 7 into 1, 7, minus 9, 6 are 54. We subtract, we get -47. And A12 odd, 1 plus 2, 3, odd, we have to change the sign, we get +7. Third is 4 into 1, 4, minus 6 into 5, 30, we got -26. 1 plus 3, even, so the sign remains same, -26. 0 into 7, which is 0, minus 6 into 2, 12, we get -12. 2 plus 1, 3, odd, we have to change the sign, so we get +12. 7 into 3, 21, minus 6 into 2, 12, we get 9. 2 plus 2, even, so sign remains same. 4 into 3, 12, minus 6 into 0, 0, we get 12. 2 plus 3, 5, odd, sign will be changed, we get -12. 9 into 0, 0, minus 5 into 2, 10, we get -10. 3 plus 1, 4, even, sign will be same. Now calculate 3 into 9, 27, minus 2 into 1, 2, we get 25. 3 plus 2, 5, odd, we have to change the sign, minus 25. 5 into 3, 15, minus 0, we get 15. 3 plus 3, 6, sign will be 6. So please make a note and check all the cofactors are same or not. So please check it, what cofactor is wrong, what is this. A21, please make a note here. A21, second row, first column. If we remove second row and first column, we got 0, 2, 4, and 7. 0, 2, 4, and 7. So, but we will got 7 into 0, 0, 4 into 2, 8. We got -8. So, 2 plus 1, 3, odd. So, we have to change the sign. We get +8. And the remaining elements are same. So, please make a note. Now we have to find adjoints. What will be the adjoint? Adjoint is cofactor matrix transpose. So we already got the cofactor matrix. Now change the sign. Means change the row into column. Our first row is -1, -47, -26. Second is 8, 9, -12. Third is -10, -25, and 50. This is our adjoint. Now what we have to obtain? A inverse. So for this we have to write first A matrices. What the A matrices is? 3 1 6 0 5 4 2 9 7. Now we have to calculate the determinant. Extend along R1. So the elements are 3 0 2. First element positive, negative, positive. What we have to do? Remove first column, we got 5 4 9 7. Remove second row first column, we got 1 6 9 7. Remove third column first row, we got 1 6 5 4. Now solve this. 3 into 7 into 5 35, 9 4 are 36. If you multiply 0, we get the answer 0 plus 2. 4 into 1 4, minus 6 into 5 30. 3 into minus 1 plus 2 into minus 26. So we get minus 33 minus 52. Answer is minus 55, which is not equal to 0. It means the inverse is possible for the this matrix. And we know V is what is basically A inverse. So this will be adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. What's the adjoints? This is the adjoints. -1 47 -26 8 9 -12 -10 -25 15. And what's the determinant is? Is -55. So I am dividing by -1, so we get the change the sign. I will call 1 by 55 1 47 26. -8 -9 12 10 25 -15. This is your final answer. So please make a note first. Our next important property is, if the A is your invertible matrix, then the transpose of a matrix, and if we take its inverse, will be same as if we first find the inverse of the matrix, then we will take its transpose. The result will be same. So this property we have to prove in according to our question number 8 and 7 and question. You have to do it yourself because it is same. If A is 2, 3, 1 and 5, and verify the result. This is your property. Now please do it. Firstly, you have to calculate the transpose. So I am getting firstly transpose. This is basically 2 cross 2. So it's very easy, because we know that trick to calculate the A inverse within 5 seconds. A is our 2, 1, 3, 5. And what we will be, its inverse is adjoint divided by determinant. And we know the what's the adjoint. We have to interchange. We get 5, 2, and the sign of the remaining elements will be changed. And what will be the determinants? 2 into 5, 10, minus 3 into 1, 3. So we get 5, minus 1, minus 3, 2, divided by 7, which is equal to 1 by 7, 5, minus 1, minus 3, 2. This is our A inverse. Now we have to just find out and we have to verify. Now I am taking our, firstly I have to take transpose. Our left hand side is what? Left hand side is A transpose inverse. Firstly we have to calculate the transpose. What's the transpose is? A, this is, what is transpose? 2, 1, this is 2, 1, this is 3, 5, 3, 5. So it means we have to calculate the inverse of the this matrices. Then what will be the x? Firstly we have to calculate the inverse. We have to calculate the inverse of this matrix. It means adjoints of A transpose divided by determinant of A transpose. Now do it same as, what is its adjoints? Change the diagonal elements, 5 and 2. We get 5, 2, and the remaining element sign will be changed, minus 3 and minus 3. What will be determinants? 5 into 2, 10, 1 into 3, 3. So we get 1 by 7, 5 minus 1 minus 3 and 4. So we get A transpose inverse. And this is our left hand side. This is our left hand side. Now we have to calculate our right hand side. What will be the right hand side is? We have to take the transpose of A inverse matrix. And we already got. If we take its transpose, then the 1 by 7 is your scalar number. It will remain same. And this is your A inverse. So we have to take its transpose, change row into column. If we change row into column, we will get 5 minus 1 minus 3 into 2. Now check it. 1 by 7, 5 minus 3 minus 1 2, 5 minus 3 minus 1 and 2. It means left hand side is equal to right hand side. So it's very, very, very easy. Please make a note first. Our next property is property number 6. If we want to calculate the inverse of multiplication of two matrices, then the same result will be can obtain by taking individually inverse of the matrix and you have to multiply them. But remember that the order of the matrix is changed. Means A into B. So we got the AB into A. Same as in transpose. What's the transpose? AB transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. Same here. What's the adjoint of AB is? Adjoint of B into adjoint of A. Similar in this. What are we? AB inverse. AB inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. So we have to verify this property. So we have to calculate the inverse. Firstly, I am taking AB if the matrix A is given as 2, 3, 1, minus 4 and B matrix is given as 1, minus 1, minus 2 and 3. Now first I have to calculate the AB. Now we have to do multiply A into B, which is 2, 3, 1, minus 4 and what is B? 1, minus 1, minus 2 and 3. Now do multiplication. 2 into 1, 2. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. 2 into minus 2, minus 4. 3 into 3, 9. 1 into 1, 1. Minus 4 into minus 1, minus plus 4. 1 into minus 2, minus 2. Minus 4 into 3, minus 12. We got our matrices. 2 minus 3, minus 1. Minus 9 plus, plus 5. 5 and minus 14. Now we have to take its inverse. AB inverse means adjoint of AB divided by determinant of AB. So we have to calculate firstly adjoints. I am using shortcut method. We have to interchange these elements. Minus 14, minus 1 and change the sign. Minus 5, minus 5. Now we have to take determinants. Minus 1 into minus 14 we get plus 14. Minus 5 into 5, 25. Which is equal to minus 14, minus 5, minus 5 and minus 1. What's the result? Minus 11. If we solve this, we get 1 by 11. And change divide by negative 14, 5, 5, 1. This is our answer, our left hand side. So please make a note first. Now I am writing here, we already got our left hand side, then we have to go to our right hand side. Right hand side is B inverse into A inverse. It means we have to first calculate the A inverse and B inverse. Then we have to do multiplication. So this is our A. And what will be the its inverse is? A inverse is, I am using shortcut method. We have to change the order of the elements. Here we get minus 4, 2. Now the sign of the element will be changed. Minus 3 and minus 1 and divide by its determinants. What's the determinant? Minus 4 into 2, minus 8, minus 3 into 1 plus 3. So we get A inverse is equal to minus 8 plus 3, minus 7, minus 4, minus 1, minus 3, 2, divide by minus 5. Now we divide by minus 5 and what will be the result? 4, 1, 3, 2, 1 upon 5. This is our A inverse. Now we have to do for B. B is our matrices 1, minus 2, minus 1, 3. Then what will be the inverse? Firstly, adjoint of P. Now change the order 3, 1. Change the sign 2, 1. Divide by determinants 3 into 1, 3. Minus, minus 2 into minus 1, 2. Means 3 minus 2. So we got B inverse is 3, 2, 1, 1. Because 3 minus 2, 1. So answer will be 3. This is our A inverse and B inverse. Now we have to calculate the right hand side. Right hand side is what? This is our left hand side. And now we have to solve our right hand side. What's the right hand side is? B inverse into A inverse. B inverse into A inverse. What is B inverse? 3, 2, 1, 1. What is A inverse is? 1 by 5. So I am writing here 1 by 5 here. And what is A? 4, 3, 1, 2. So please make a note first and check all the elements are same or not. Please make a correction here. A is 2, 3, 1 and minus 1. We are taking adjoints. Adjoints is minus 4 and 2 is a take. And 3 and 1, we have to change the order. Again, correct. Now, what are the determinants? Minus 4 into 2, minus 8. Then, minus 1 into 3, 3. It means we get here minus 3. So, in this, we get here minus 11. Now, if we divide minus 1, minus minus plus 4, plus 1, plus 3, and this is minus 2. We get here 1 by 11. So, do correction here. So, I am writing here 1 by 11 and we got 4, 3, 1 and minus 2. Now, do multiplications. 1 by 11, 3 into 4, 12, 2 into 1, 2, 3 into 3, 9, 2 into minus 2, minus 4, 1 into 4, 4, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 3, 3, 1 into minus 2, minus 2. It means we got 1 by 11, 12 plus 2, 14, 9 minus 4, 5, 4 plus 1, 5, or 3 minus 2, 1. This is our right hand side. So, it is clearly visible left hand side is equal to right hand side. So, this property is true. So, make a note first. If you really like my video, so do subscribe and do like. And don't forget to share to your friends also. I have complete exercise 5.2 up to question number 10. And the remaining question we will do in our next lecture. And if you are reading from your NCERT, then this is the part of your exercise 4.4. And we already taken 5.1 exercise, which is your first 5 question. And these questions are the remaining questions from your exercise 4.4 from your NCERT. And those students which are reading from the element mathematics, this is exercise 5.2 and we completed from questions 10. Then we will start from question 11 onwards. To see my video from start to end, I really thank you. Then we will meet soon to take you to another video.